38 dancing. I am a can of whoop ass ready to open. I really wish these niggas would stop fronting on me.
Niggas try to front, we move on them. Niggas think something sweet till we move on them.
SlickJC, your notorious B.I.G. brother in gaming. If you can tell by the fancy, funky, short intro. Anyway, this is a private gun game from the point of view of my TFS homeboy, only one, just Josh. Now, me, Josh, and Phil, aka Son of Jarrell 1, were on the game one afternoon. It was kind of boring. We couldn't really get into no good lobbies. Decided, yo, let's play a gun game. Just for fun, shits and giggles. So we get on the gun game, and it was already thought that I would win this match. But like I said in Female Game of Week, never underestimate your opponent. Now, Josh has the lowest kill death ratio and win percent than me and Phil. But he actually pulls off the win in this one. And it was so funny, I said, yo, I'm going to post it up on my channel. Just for the hell of it. So here it is. Topic I want to get into today is something I saw on TV of the week. Well, actually this week, earlier this week. You know, I made that commentary about white people and the supernatural. I was talking about that movie Sinister and Barricade and some other movie that had advertised and whatnot. So I watched the TV this past week, and what comes on my TV that comes out, I think October 19th or around the 30th? Paranormal Activity 4. Really, people? Have we not milked the cow enough already? I'm sure the cow teats are very sore. Why in the world do we have a part 4 of Paranormal Activity? Now, I got to admit, the first three, you know, were good. Especially how it all rounded up at the end and you saw how it all was connected and stuff. They went back and told like a little some backstory. So yeah, that was good. What in the world is 4 going to be about? Like, really? And once again, this is only happening to white people. Like, really, I'm like so glad to be black. But let me tell you, you know, when I asked you about a black horror film and what would it be like if you thought it'd be real scary, and I told you I thought mine would be funny, we actually did have a black horror movie. But it was one movie. It was about maybe about 90 minutes long. But the black horror movie of it only lasted about maybe 30 minutes. Who's old enough that's watching this video remember the movie Candyman? You know, the movie Candyman with the dude Tony Todd, he played this pretty much this ghost. And if you look in the mirror 5 times and said his name, like the lights will go out and he'll appear behind you and kill you. Yeah. Candyman was the movie. And when the movie starts off, he's based in Chicago. Not in the Chicago suburbs. He's in the Chicago hood. Cabrini Green Projects, this is. In fact, Cabrini Green Projects doesn't even exist anymore. Like, they tore the projects down now. But he was in this project haunting black people. And black people were scared of him. And he was this urban legend in the hood. Now, of course, the film had to have the lead white actress. So now the movie goes from being focused on the black people in the hood to the lead white actress. Now, we can't even have a horror movie to ourselves. Now then, the white people and their love for the supernatural and being able to contact them steal our own movie. Really, Hollywood? Really? But people in Cabrini Green didn't even need Candyman to even make it a horror movie. You can see the grandma in the projects right now. The 15th come, she go check her mailbox. The check ain't there. Horror. Go pay the rent, and you get your paycheck, and you about $50 short on the rent. Horror. Go to your car to go to work, and you got a boot on your car for too many parking tickets. Horror. Black people, we don't need the supernatural to have horror in our lives. We don't need to talk to ghosts to have horror in our lives. We don't need nothing in the living room to go floating across the room to have horror in our lives. Basic everyday problems sometimes is horror for us. So all the white people, y'all can talk to all the ghosts, all the spirits, do all the seances you want. Us black people, we stick with real life horror. And that's all I got to say about that. Now, what movies are y'all looking forward to coming out this year? Now, I see the new James Bond is coming out sometime in November. Got the Silent Hill Revelations coming out near the end of October. Which it looks like they're trying to reboot the whole franchise because it looks more like the video game than the other piece of crap did. I'm trying to think. You got a crazy movie with Kevin James. He's like a MMA fighter or something. I really want to see Taken 2. But I don't know. I mean, speaking of Taken, I was pretty spoiled by that movie. Because honestly, when the first Taken came out, it came out overseas about a whole year before it came out to the U.S. And before it came out to the U.S., in fact, when it was advertised in the movie theater as a preview in the U.S., 2 days later, I downloaded the international version off the internet. And of course, the international version is much more violent than the PG version that they released in the U.S. So now with Taken 2 being PG-13, I know there's an R-rated version that was released overseas. I just feel like if I can't find it, I just wait till the movie comes out on Blu-ray. Because you really can't have an action movie with a bunch of guns and stuff and make it PG-13. This PG-13 era of everything really sucks. From movies, even to my favorite thing I like to watch on TV, wrestling, the WWE. And PG-13 is killing the vibe of everything. Bring it back to some hardcore stuff. I don't need to see a whole lot of blood and guts and people pulling their intestines out. But I remember when an action movie and a horror movie was rated R. I remember watching Friday the 13th, the Nightmare on Elm Street, and literally being scared to go to sleep. Now for Friday the 13th or Nightmare on Elm Street comes out, it's PG-13, and it's pretty much comical. Like, really, this is supposed to scare me? A bunch of jump scares? Come on now. Show me something scary. Show me something R-rated. Like, the only time a movie get R-rated now, if a woman shows her breast and a little bit of her patch for like 20 seconds on screen. Really, people, is this what R-rated reduced to? I remember when the movie Porky's came out and the girls were full frontal nude for like 10 minutes and the movie was rated PG and it was a comedy. Come on now, have we gotten that proved in society that all of a sudden we just can't show nothing? Like everything has to be PG or it's not made at all, it's not seen at all? Pretty soon, people saying cuss words in movies is going to make the movie X-rated. Like, you can't say the F word but 10 times in the movie. At the 11th time, your movie's going to be rated R. Come on, America. Wake up. That's 2012. We're in a whole new society. We moving on to the future. Let them F-bombs out. Show me some blood and guts. Give me a horror movie that's actually gonna scare me. Give me an action movie where I can see somebody get their neck broke. Give me some wrestling where I can see somebody actually hit somebody. Bring the Attitude Era back. And if you want to show some naked women, show some naked women, because I'm ready to see them. And that's it. That's all I got for you. It's SlickJC, Notorious B.I.G., but you already knew that. Brother in Gaming, peace out.